So, dear students, again I'll continue the second session of the afternoon, that is by Tungaraju sir. So, I welcome Mr. Tungaraju GD, co-founder of People Mechanics and founder of TICE. I welcome you, sir. Tungaraju sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes. Can you able to hear me, sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, sir. So now let me give the brief introduction of Tungaraju sir. So Tungaraju GD is a co-founder of People Mechanics, founder of TICE, completed diploma in mechanical engineering from Bahubali Polytechnic, Shravanabelagola, and got selected for JSW Steels, Bellary. After serving for 3 years, joined engineering and graduated from Bahubali College of Engineering. Sir was passionate about the business. Joined a small-scale industry called Sri Datta Engineers for the better exposure of the same and served for 2 years. Later, with this experience in manufacturing sector, sir started People Mechanics Company in December 2014. People Mechanics is engaged in manufacturing of aerospace components, machinery components, automobile components, jigs and fixtures, special purpose machines, mechanical automation and customized requirements based on the customer needs. So in order to come up the gap between the industry and educational sector, sir provoked to bridge a gap between the help with the industry expert, which lead to the start of TICE, that is Team of Industrial Expert Creating Entrepreneurs Through Education, in September 2020. The vision of TICE is to educate students to become an entrepreneurs. In this process of creating entrepreneurs, sir is training the students to become industry ready. So I welcome you to the session, sir.
Thank you, madam. Thank you so much.
Over to Tungaraju, sir.
Yes. Good afternoon, all.
So students will be mute, so they can ask the question within the chat box. For that, you can answer.
Fine. Yes, very good afternoon. I am Tungaraju, one of the founder of company People Mechanics, also founder of TICE. Basically, I'm a mechanical engineer having 10 plus years experience in the manufacturing sector. Also, I'm a mentor to engineering students where I taken a session on entrepreneurship for more than 1,200 people. So this session is all about how to become an entrepreneur. Even though you don't have any investment, even though you don't have any background support, you can also become an entrepreneur and also you can earn in terms of crores. So this session, I will going to guide you on how to become an entrepreneur and how to become successful in life, right? So before going to start, so let's start with the video. Please go through the video.
Good times, difficult times. My question to all of you is, you want what? Good times or difficult times? What do you want? Good times. Good decision. Happiness is a good time. Love, being loved, beautiful. Success, good time. Confidence, good time. Harmonious relationships, good time. Health, good times. Now, when do you remember the God the maximum? Prayers, faith, when you are more disciplined. When are you more humble? When are you more humble? When you put more efforts, difficult times. When you give your best, difficult time, give your best. Happiness makes you lazy. Happiness makes you indisciplined. Moment all of you laugh, you disturb everybody. He is focusing. You have a tummy. Huh? You're happy about it. मैं पूछ रहा हूँ क्या है prosperity? Now when you're happy with the tummy, will you work out or what? You won't work out. So happiness makes you lazy. It makes you love makes you pampered. Success gives you ego. Confidence makes you arrogant. When relationship is going very nicely, you take for granted. And when you are healthy, you are very casual. But when you have stomach upset, when you have loose motion, it is going on coming, and you're singing ruk ruk ruk, are baba ruk, but nahi, it's going on coming, going on coming, going on coming, and you promise, in that difficult time, you promise, I will eat good food. Discipline, what commitments you gave in difficult time, and after 2 days when it became okay. So look at life. What happens here is, the good times bring worst out of you, and difficult times brings best out of you. In fact, it should be the other way. In fact, when you are in the good times, if you can do what you do in bad times, you will never have difficult times. In good times, bad times, God will be there. Good times, bad times, prayers will be there. Good times, best, bad times, I will give my best. Good times, difficult times, what is there? What I do here, I'll make it as my nature. You will never have to go through difficult times in life. So ask yourself, when bad happens to you, what you should do? Become better. How to become better? Ensure that you practice all these things which came out of you only in difficult time. Practice it even in the good times. You will never have to wear two. Then you will never have this question, why bad is happening to me? Bad will never happen to you. You will know that it's a system which works, and even if you have to overcome some tough times, it's only going to beautify you, make you glitter and make you better. And that's the only thing.
So, was that useful? Type out in the chat box. Yes. So, before going to start, let's start with a point of view story. So, you have already kelor helidru. So, there is no scope for engineering. Some of you are complaining. There is no scope for engineering. Your parents are not supporting to do engineering and all, right? So,
students said that it was a useful, you have asked. So, they said that, nice sir, yes sir, it was very useful. This was the comment. It was in a chat box.
Yes, thank you. Yeah. Thank you. So, let's start with the point of your story. So, fine. When the aane irutte, okay? ಆನೆನ ನೋಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಜನ ಕುರುಡ್ರು ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಫೋರ್ ಬ್ಲೈಂಡ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಯುನೋ ಗೋ ಟು ಸಿ ಅನ್ ಎಲಿಫೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಆನೆ ನೋಡಕ್ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ, ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಕಣ್ ಕಾಣಲ್ಲ. ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಅವ್ರು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಆನೆ ಹತ್ರಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ, ಆನೆನ ಮುಟ್ಟಿ ನೋಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಆನೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೋಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹೋಗ್ತಾನೆ, ಆನೆ ಕಾಲನ್ನ ಮುಟ್ತಾನೆ. ಸೊ ಆನೆ ಲೆಗ್ ಟಚ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಆನೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅವನು ಪಿಲ್ಲರ್ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೋತಾನೆ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬ ಹೋಗ್ತಾನೆ, ಸೊ ಆನೆ ಬಾಲ ಮುಟ್ತಾನೆ, ಟೈಲ್ ಮುಟ್ತಾನೆ. ಸೊ ಆನೆ ಬಾಲ ಮುಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆನೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಸ್ನೇಕ್ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೋತಾನೆ. ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆನೆ ಹೊಟ್ಟೆ ಮುಟ್ತಾನೆ, ಸೊ ಆನೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ವಾಲ್ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೋತಾನೆ. ಸೊ ಮತ್ತೊಬ್ಬ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆನೆ ಕಿವಿನ ಮುಟ್ತಾನೆ, ಸೊ ಆನೆ ಅಂತಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಬೀಸಣಿಗೆ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ, ಫ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಫ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೋತಾನೆ. ಸೊ ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ನಾವೇನಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವ್ಯೂ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಇದು ನಮ್ಮ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ಗೆ ನಾವೇ ಖುದ್ದಾಗಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿಬೋದು ಅದನ್ನ. ಸೊ ಆನೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಖುದ್ದಾಗಿ ಆನೆ ಮುಟ್ ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀನಪ್ಪ, ಆನೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪಿಲ್ಲರ್ ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವ್ಯೂ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಬಟ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ನಮ್ಮ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವ್ಯೂವೇ ಸರಿ ಅಂತ ಯಾವಾಗ ಅನ್ಕೋತೀವಿ ಅವಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ನಮಗೆ ಒಂದು ಆನೆದು ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಕ್ಲಾರಿಟಿ ಸಿಗಲ್ಲ. ಲೈಫ್ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಆನೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಂಬ ಅನ್ಕೊಂಡೇ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾರೆ ಕೆಲವರು, ಲೈಫ್ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಆನೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸ್ನೇಕ್ ಅಂತಾನೆ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಬಟ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ನಾವು ಎಲ್ಲರ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವ್ಯೂಲ್ಲೂ ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ನೋಡಿ ಒಂದು ಸರಿಯಾದ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ತಗೋತೀವಿ, ಆವಾಗ ಆನೆದು ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಕ್ಲಾರಿಟಿ ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಹಾಗೇನೆ ಲೈಫಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಏನೋ ಸಜೆಷನ್ಸ್, ಇದು ಸರಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಸರಿ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಅಥವಾ ಎಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಕೋಪ್ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಅಥವಾ ಎಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ತುಂಬ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ. ಸೊ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ಸ್ ಎರಡೂ ಬರ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಬಟ್ ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಡೇ ಸೊ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವ್ಯೂ ನಾನು ಏನು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಅದೇ ಸರಿ ಅನ್ನೋದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಎಲ್ಲರ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವ್ಯೂಲ್ಲೂ ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ನೋಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ತೊಗೊಂಡಾಗ ಮಾತ್ರ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಟು ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್, ಸೊ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಈಚ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಲೈಫ್, ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್, ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕೆರಿಯರ್, ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್, ಯಾವುದೇ ವಿಷಯ ತೊಗೊಂಡ್ರೂ ಕೂಡ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬರ ಶೂವಲ್ಲೂ ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ನೋಡಿ ಒಂದು ರೈಟ್ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ತೊಗೊಂಡಾಗ ಸೊ ನಿಮಗೂ ಕೂಡ ಒಂದು ಮೆಚ್ಯೂರ್ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ತೊಗೊಂಡು ಲೈಫಲ್ಲಿ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ ಆಗೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಇದು ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಇವತ್ತು ನಾನು ಏನೇನು ಸೆಷನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ, ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್, ಮೇ ಬಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಅನುಭವ ಬಂದಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಬಂದಿಲ್ದೇನು ಇರ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ಬಟ್ ದ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ಇದಕ್ಕೂ ಮುಂಚೆ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಒಂದು ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತಾಡೋಣ. ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಅಂದರೆ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಆನ್ ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ. ಇವತ್ತಿಗೆ ಒಬ್ಬ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ತೊಗೊಂಡ್ರು ಕೂಡ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಲ್ಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಮೈಸೂರಲ್ಲಿ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ 50,000 ಫೀಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಒಂದು ಎಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಅಥವಾ ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಮುಗಿಸ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೂ ಒಬ್ಬ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟು ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಅಂದ್ರೂ 15-20 lakhs ಖರ್ಚು ಮಾಡಿರ್ತಾರೆ, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ 15-20 lakh ರುಪೀಸ್. ಅದ್ರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ 21-22 ವರ್ಷ ಬರೀ ಓದೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂತಲೇ ನೀವು ಸೀಮಿತವಾಗಿಟ್ಟಿರ್ತೀರ ಟೈಮ್ನ. ಸೊ 20 ವರ್ಷ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ಗೆ ಅಂತ ಟೈಮ್ ಸ್ಪೆಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಿ 20 lakh ದುಡ್ಡನ್ನು ಖರ್ಚು ಮಾಡಿ ಅದೇ 20 lakhs ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ನ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಅಕೌಂಟಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಇವತ್ತು ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ 10-20 years ಫಾರ್ ಯು ಟು ಅರ್ನ್ ದ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್. ಹೌದಾ? ಸೊ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಅಂತ. ಇವತ್ತು ಏನು ಓದಿಲ್ದಿರೋ ಒಬ್ಬ ಓಲಾ ಯೂಬರ್ ಡ್ರೈವರ್ ತೊಗೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಇವತ್ತು ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿಗೆ ಬಂದರೆ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ 30-40,000 ಪರ್ ಮಂತ್ ಅರ್ನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಬಟ್ ಅದೇ ಒಬ್ಬ ಎನಿ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಜುಯೇಟ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್, ಯಾವುದೇ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಜುಯೇಟ್ ಕೂಡ ಇವತ್ತು ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿಗೆ ಬಂದರೆ ಟು ಅರ್ನ್ ದಟ್ 40-50,000 ಮನಿ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ 55 years ಆಫ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್. 5 ವರ್ಷ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಆದರೂ ಕೂಡ ಮೋರ್ ದೆನ್ 80% ಆಫ್ ದ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಜುಯೇಟ್ಸ್ ಈವನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಗ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕ್ರಾಸ್ 50,000 ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ. ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್? ಯಾಕೆ ಓದ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ. ರೈಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಎಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಯಾಕೆ ತೊಗೊಂಡ್ರಿ ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ? ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್? ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕೆರಿಯರ್ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ ಏನು? ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಹೇಳಿದಾಗೆ ಯಾರೋ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ತೊಗೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಸ್ಕೋಪ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಎ ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ವೇರ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್, ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಅಥವಾ ಡ್ರೀಮ್ ಕಂಪ್ನಿ ಸೊ ಈ ಥರ ಇನ್ಫೋಸಿಸಲ್ಲಿ ಸೇರಿಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಅಥವಾ ಬೆನ್ಸಲ್ ಸೇರಿಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಏನಿದೆ? ಸೊ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ನನಗೆ 20,000 ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ ಸಿಗುತ್ತಪ್ಪ ಯಾವುದೇ ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಂಚಲ್ಲಿ ಇದು ತೊಗೊಂಡ್ರು, ಅಥವಾ ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ವೇರ್ಗೆ ಹೋದರೆ 30,000 ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ, 300,000 ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ, ಸೊ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಯಾಕೇಜ್ 100,000 ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ, 200,000 ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಯುವರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟೇಷನ್ಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ನಿಮ್ಮ ಸೀನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಒಂದು ಸರ್ವೇನ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ, ಸೊ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಸೀನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹೌ ದೇ ಸ್ಟಡೀಡ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಏನಾಯ್ತು ಅಂದರೆ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ನೈಟ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ. ನಾಳೆ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಇವತ್ತು ರಾತ್ರಿಯೆಲ್ಲ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಓದ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಓದ್ತಾರೆ, ಓದಿದ್ರು, ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ತೆಗೆದ್ರು, ಯಾರು ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಕಾರ್ಡಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿದ್ರು ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಡಿಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್, ಅದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಕಮ್ಮಿ ಇಲ್ವೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ರನ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಬಿಹೈಂಡ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ತಲೆ ಕೆಡಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿಲ್ಲ, ನೀವು ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಟೆಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೂ ನಿಮಗೆ ಅಟೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗಬೇಕು. ಸೀನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಸೊ ಯು ಆರ್ ದ ಫ್ರೆಷರ್, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಸೀನಿಯರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಏನು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಇತ್ತು, ಅವ್ರು ಏನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು, ಇವತ್ತು ಏನಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅನ್ನೋದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಟೆಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೂ ಅಟೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು, ಇಂಟರ್ನಲ್ಸ್ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಬರೀಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೂ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು. ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಡೇ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೂ ಕೂಡ ಏನೋ ಒಂದು ಸರ್ಟಿಫಿಕೇಟ್, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ನಾನು ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಅನ್ನೋ ಒಂದು ಸರ್ಟಿಫಿಕೇಟ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟರೆ ಒಂದು ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಮುಗಿಯುತ್ತಪ್ಪ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ನಾನು ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಕೆಲಸಕ್ಕೆ ತಗೋಬೋದು. ಇಷ್ಟಕ್ಕಷ್ಟೇ ಸೀಮಿತವಾಗಿ ಓದಿದ್ರೆ ಹೊರತು ನಾಲೆಜ್ ತೊಗೊಬೇಕು ಅಥವಾ ಇದು ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ಸ್ಗಳನ್ನ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋ ಕಾರಣಕ್ಕೆ ಯಾವತ್ತೂ ಓದಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ. ಏನಾಯಿತು ಇದರಿಂದ, ವಾಟ್ ವೆಂಟ್ ರಾಂಗ್ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಇಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್, ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ಸ್ಗಳಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಗೆ ಇವತ್ತು ಏನು ನೀಡಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಡೇ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಶೀಟಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಸೊ ಎಲ್ಲರ ಹತ್ರನೂ ಡಿಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಇದೆ, ಬಟ್ ಕೆಲ್ಸಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಬಂದಾಗ ಯಾರೂ ಇಂಟರ್ವ್ಯೂ ಅಟೆಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಅಥವಾ 90% ಆಫ್ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಎ ರೈಟ್ ಜಾಬ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಡೊಮೈನ್. ವಾಟ್ ಚಾಲೆಂಜಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಫೇಸಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಸೊ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಜಾಬ್, ಅಥವಾ ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ ಕಮ್ಮಿ. ಮೆಕ್ಯಾನಿಕಲ್ ಅಂದರೆ 15,000 ಕರೀತಾರೆ, ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ವೇರ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೂ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಇದೆ. ಏನೋ ಒಂದು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕಂಪ್ನಿಗೆ ಹೋದರೆ 15,000-20,000 ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಲೇಮಿಂಗ್ ಗೇಮ್, ನೋ ಸ್ಕೋಪ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಯಾವ ಕಾಲೇಜಲ್ಲೂ ಕ್ಯಾಂಪಸ್ ಇಂಟರ್ವ್ಯೂ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಸ್ಕೋಪ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ಗೆ, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಡ್. ಈಗ ನಿಮಗೂ ಕೆಲವೊಬ್ರು ಹೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಕೋಪ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ. ಸಿ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ನ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಹೇಗೆ ಓದಬೇಕು ಓದಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ. ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಡೇ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು, ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ತೊಗೊಂಡ್ರು, ಡಿಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಷನ್ ತೆಗೆದ್ರು, ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ತಲೆ ಕೆಡಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಒಂದು ಸರಿ ಅವ್ರ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಏನಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಸೊ ನಾನು ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಓದಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ. ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಡೇ ಬ್ಲೇಮಿಂಗ್ ಏನು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಯಿತು, ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಕೊಡಿಸ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಕಾಲೇಜಲ್ಲಿ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ತರಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಫಾರ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್. ಇದು ಇವತ್ತವರೆಗೂ ಹಬ್ಬಿರೋವಂಥ ವಿಷಯ ಅಂತ. ಬಟ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಸಿಚುಯೇಷನ್ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, 80% ಆಫ್ ದ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ಈವನ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಪ್ಯಾಂಡಮಿಕ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ರೈಟ್ ಜಾಬ್, ಡೊಮೈನಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ರೈಟ್ ಜಾಬ್ ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಕೋವಿಡ್ ಸಿಚುಯೇಷನ್ ಬಂದಾಗ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಟುಗೆದರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್, ಸಾವಿರಾರು ಜನ, ಲಕ್ಷಾಂತರ ಜನ ಕೆಲಸ ಕಳ್ಕೊತಾ ಹೋದ್ರು ಅಂತ. ಡಿಮ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಓವರ್ ಸಪ್ಲೈ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದೀರಾ? ಒಂದೇ ಸಲ ಈರುಳ್ಳಿ ಬೆಲೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾ, ಟೊಮೆಟೊ ಬೆಲೆ ಒಂದೇ ಸಲ 50 ರೂಪಾಯಿ 100 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಯಾವಾಗ ಡಿಮ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಟೊಮೆಟೊ ಬೆಳೀತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ. ಏನಾಯಿತು, ಟೊಮೆಟೊ ಬೆಳೆದ್ರು ಬೆಳೆದ್ರು ಬೆಳೆದ್ರು, ಬಟ್ ಡಿಮ್ಯಾಂಡೇ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಸಪ್ಲೈ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗೋಯಿತು. ಸೊ 10 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಕೆ ಜಿ ತೊಗೊಳಕ್ಕೂ ಬಂದರು 2 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ತೊಗೊಳಕ್ಕೂ ಬಂದರು, ಅಟ್ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಏನೋ 1 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗೋಗ್ತಿದೆ, 1 ರೂಪಾಯಿನಾರು ಕೊಟ್ಟು ತಗೋ ಅನ್ನೋ ಲೆವೆಲಿಗೆ. ಇವತ್ತಿಗೆ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ದು ಸಪ್ಲೈ, ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ದು ಸಪ್ಲೈ ಆ ರೀತಿ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದೆ. ಬಟ್ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಒಂದು ಕಡೆ ಸಪ್ಲೈ ಇದೆ ತುಂಬ, ಬಟ್ ಡಿಮ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ. ಲಕ್ಷಾಂತರ ಜನ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಚೆಗೆ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಸಪ್ಲೈ ಮನೆಗೆ ಒಬ್ಬರು ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಮನೆಗೆ ಇಬ್ಬರು ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್. ರೋಡಲ್ಲಿ ತೊಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬರು ಮನೇಲೂ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಬಟ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ಸ್ಗಳಿಗೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಕೊಡೋಂಥ ಕಂಪ್ನಿಗಳೇ ಹುಟ್ಟಾಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ, ತುಂಬ ಕಮ್ಮಿ ಜನ ಆಂಟರ್ಪ್ರಿನರ್ಸ್ಗಳಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಆದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ವೆರಿ ಹೈ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟೇಷನ್. ಅಂತಂದರೆ ನಾನು ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಇನ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್, ಸೊ ನನಗೆ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ 25,000 ಸ್ಯಾಲರಿನೇ ಬೇಕಪ್ಪ, ಇಲ್ಲಾಂದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಬರೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ನೋ ಯುವರ್ ಸೀನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ 25,000 ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ ಬೇಕು, ಅದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಕಮ್ಮಿ. ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿಗೆ ಏನು ಸರ್, ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿಗೆ ಬಂದರೆ ನನಗೆ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ 25,000 ಬೇಕು ಸರ್, ಇದು ಪಿ ಜಿ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು, ಊಟ ತಿಂಡಿ ಓಡಾಟ 25,000 ಇಲ್ಲ ಹೇಗೆ ಬರೋಣ? ಸೊ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಲೋ ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ ಜಾಬ್ಗಳನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ರಿಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ. 1 ವರ್ಷ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, 1 ವರ್ಷ ಇಡೀ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಸುತ್ತಿದ್ರು ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗೋದೇನಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಬಂದಾಗ ಫ್ರೆಷರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಇಷ್ಟೇ ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ ಅಂತ, ಬಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ರೆಡಿ ಟು ಅಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ, ಬಟ್ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಡೇಸಲ್ಲಿ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಸೊ ಕೆಲಸ ರಿಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತೀರಾ, ಬೆಂಗಳೂರೆಲ್ಲ ಸುತ್ತೀರಾ, ಅಷ್ಟರಲ್ಲಿ 1 ವರ್ಷ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಈ ಕಡೆ 1 ವರ್ಷ ನೀವು ಓದಿದ್ದು ಮರ್ತೋಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಈ ಕಡೆ 1 ವರ್ಷ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯೆನ್ಸು ಇರಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಏನಾಗ್ತಿದೆ, ಐಡಲ್ ಟೈಮ್. 1 ವರ್ಷ ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಖಾಲಿ ಮನೇಲಿ ಕೂತಿರ್ತೀರಾ, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯೆನ್ಸು ಇಲ್ಲ. ಅಟ್ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ 10,000 ಸಂಬಳಕ್ಕೆ ಸೇರಿಕೊಂಡ್ರು ಕೂಡ ಇವಡ ಏನೋ 1 ಲಾಕ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್, ಅದು ದುಡ್ಡಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ. ಅಷ್ಟರಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಚೆಗೆ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ. 2020 ಆದರೆ 2021 ಬ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಚೆಗೆ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ. ಇವ್ರು 1 ವರ್ಷ ಹಳಬರಾಗಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟಲ್ಲಿ ಫ್ರೆಶ್ ತರಕಾರಿಗೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದು ಬೆಲೆ ಇರುತ್ತಾ, ಅಥವಾ 1 ವರ್ಷ ಹಳೆದು 1 ದಿನ 2 ದಿನ ಹಿಂದಿದ ಹಳೆದಕ್ಕೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಡೇ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಫ್ರೆಷರ್ಸ್ ಇರೋನೇ ತಗೋತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಬಂದಾಗ ಯಾವತ್ತಿಗೂ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅ ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಗೈನ್ ಸಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯೆನ್ಸ್. ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯೆನ್ಸ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯೆನ್ಸ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಆ ಒಂದು ಡೊಮೈನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್ ತಗೊಂಡ ಮೇಲೆ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಅ ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ. ಏನಾಗಿದೆ, ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸು ಅಥವಾ ಲಾಯರ್ಸ್ಗಳು ಅಂತ ತೊಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಅವ್ರು 1 ವರ್ಷ 2 ವರ್ಷ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಆಮೇಲೇ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಕ್ಲೈಂಟ್ ಸಿಗ್ತಾರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಇನ್ನೊಂದೇನೋ ಇದು ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಬಟ್ ಇವತ್ತಿಗೆ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟಿಂಗಲ್ಲೇ ಅಟ್ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಪೇಯಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಇದು ಹೀಗೆ ಮುಂದುವರೆದ್ರೆ, ನೀವು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಸೀನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಥರನೇ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋದರೆ, ಬರೀ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಕಾರ್ಡಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ಸ್ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಏನೂ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ನಾಳೆ ದಿನ ನೀವು ಕೂಡ 6 ತಿಂಗಳು 1 ವರ್ಷ ಫ್ರೀಯಾಗಿ ವರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಕಾಲ ತುಂಬ ದೂರ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ. ಫ್ರೀಯಾಗಿ ವರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನಿಮ್ಮನ್ನು ನೀವು ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ನಂತರ ಸೊ ನಿಮಗೆ ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಏನಾಗ್ತಿದೆ ಸೀನಿಯರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಅಂದರೆ, ಇರ್ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಆಫ್ ದೇರ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕಲ್ ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್, ದೇ ನೀಡ್ ಎ ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ. ಇದು ಅವರ ಒಂದು ಬ್ಲೇಮಿಂಗ್ ಗೇಮ್ ನಡೀತಾ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಅವ್ರಿಗೇನು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಕಂಪ್ನಿನೇ ಬೇಕು, ಬಿಗ್ ಕಂಪ್ನಿ ವರ್ಸಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯೀಸ್. ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಸ್ಕೇಲ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಗೆ ಯಾರು ಹೋಗೋರೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಡೇ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಯು, ಬಿಗ್ ಕಂಪ್ನಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಜನ ಕೆಲಸ ಇದು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಜನ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರುವಂಥ ಕಂಪ್ನಿ ಮತ್ತು ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡೆಡ್ ಕಂಪ್ನಿ ಬೇಕಾ, ಅಥವಾ ಇವನ್ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಸ್ಕೇಲ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಆದರೂ ನಿಮಗೆ ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್ ಏನು ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಥವಾ ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ ಏನು ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಯು, ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್ ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ ಆರ್ ಬಿಗ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ವರ್ಸಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯೀಸ್. ಟೈಪ್ ಔಟ್ ಇನ್ ಚಾಟ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ಯಾವ್ದು ಬೇಕು ನಿಮಗೆ. ಸೊ ರೈಟ್, ಸೊ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಬಂದಾಗ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಸ್ಕೇಲ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಲಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಕಮ್ಮಿ ಇದೆ, ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದೆ. ಆದರೆ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಒಂದು ಕಡೆ ದೇ ಆರ್ ರಿಜೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಸ್ಕೇಲ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್. ಸೊ ಬಿಗ್ ಕಂಪ್ನೀಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ವರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಸಿ ಈಗ ಸೇ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ನೀವು ಯಾವುದೋ ಟೊಯೋಟಾ ಕಂಪ್ನಿಗೆ ಸೇರ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರಿ ಅಂದ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ ಆಚೆಗೆ ಬರೋದಕ್ಕೆ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೂ 400 to 500 ಅಸೆಂಬ್ಲಿ ಲೈನ್ಸ್ಗಳಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಮನ್ನು ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆಗಿ ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಗೆ ಅಥವಾ ಒಂದು ಅಸೆಂಬ್ಲಿ ಲೈನಿಗೆ ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಥ್ರೂ ಔಟ್ ದ ಇಯರ್ ನೀವು ಮಾಡಿದ ಕೆಲಸನೇ ಮಾಡಿ. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಏನೋ ಅಸೆಂಬ್ಲಿ, ಟೈರ್ ಅಸೆಂಬ್ಲಿ ಏನೋ ಸೇರ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರಿ, ಅಥವಾ ಇನ್ನೊಂದೇನೋ ಸ್ಟೇರಿಂಗ್ ಅಸೆಂಬ್ಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಇನ್ನೊಂದೇನೋ ಡೋರ್ ಅಸೆಂಬ್ಲಿ ಈ ಥರ ಸೇರಿಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ವರ್ಷ ಪೂರ್ತಿ ಆ ಡೋರ್ ಅಸೆಂಬ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡೇ ಕಳೆದು ಬಿಟ್ಟಿರ್ತೀರಾ ಅಂತ. ಬಟ್ ಅದೇ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಸ್ಕೇಲ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಸೇರಿಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಸೊ ಈಚ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ಲೂ ನೀವು ವರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತೀರಾ. ಸೊ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಮ್ಯಾನುಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಚರಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ವೇರ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ ಸೊ ಆ್ಯಪ್ಸ್ಗಳು ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಗೊತ್ತಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಡೆವಲಪರ್ ಜಾಬ್ ಏನು ಅಥವಾ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ ಹಿಡಿಯೋದು ಹೇಗೆ, ಕ್ಲೈಂಟ್ ಇಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಏನು, ಎಲ್ಲ ವಿಷಯಗಳಲ್ಲೂ ನೀವು ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತೀರ. ಬಟ್ ನೀವು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಕಂಪ್ನಿಗೆ ಅಂತ ಸೇರಿಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಡೇ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಯು ಆರ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ಅದರಿಂದ ಆಚೆಗೆ ಏನು ಸಿಗದೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ.
ಸರ್, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೈಪ್ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ಸ್ ಓವರ್ ಹಿಯರ್.
ಯೆಸ್
ಮ್ಯಾಮ್. ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್ ಅಗೇನ್, ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್ ಸ್ಯಾಲರಿ, ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್ ಬಿಗ್ ಕಂಪನಿ, ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಿಸೆಂಟ್ ಸ್ಯಾಲರಿ.
ಯೆಸ್,
and they requested you to talk in English.
Yes, sure. So what is really important to you is it's a salary. First thing is salary, but very first thing you need to work for experience. If you don't get experience, forget about salary. So it's very difficult for you to sustain in the market or in the job. So competitions, when it comes to market, so you are competing with lakhs together graduates, right? So each and every year, minimum 1 to 2 lakh engineers are coming out from the colleges. And also there is a student from different cities or different states. So even though you win that competition, what is your salary? The salary will be minimum 15 to 20,000 rupees. Even though you have a rank, even though you have a job, but you end up getting only 15 to 20,000 salary, right? One second. Excuse me. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, my system has hanged. Can you please give me a minute?
Yeah, please, sir. Sir, unmute yourself, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Right? So, who is the loser here? So, if you keep on if you keep on blaming colleges or institutions or job, so who is the loser here? Whose responsibility is to get value out of your education? Whose responsibility is to get value out of your studies? It's your responsibility, right? So it is your responsibility as a student to get value out of your money and your time investment. So what should be your new actions? So engineering has to be done the way it is meant to be, but not the way you want it to be. So not to study for the sake of, marks or certificates. So study for the sake of knowledge. Engineers are the creator. Somebody asked, there's no scope for engineers. See, actually, there is a scope for engineering and also engineers. But if you do the program the way it is meant to be, engineering has to be done the way it is meant to be, not the way you want it to be. Engineers are the solution providers. They are the creators. If you take any of the product or any of a building, you take any building, laptops, whether it is a kitchen equipment, systems, cloth, everything, it is a creation of engineer. But nowadays, engineering is only meant to get a job. Apart from getting a job, so nobody is looking into creativity. Nobody is looking into solving the problems in the society. Right? So that is why people are, speaking that there is no scope for engineering. Actually, there is a scope for engineers who can solve problems in the society. And you should do with a discipline. What is discipline? Discipline is do what is necessary, whether you like it or not. Irrespective of your likes and dislikes, you need to do the engineering the way it is meant to be. Not to worry about attendance, not to worry about internal marks. So gain knowledge. If you do the engineering in that way, definitely you will get succeeded. So according to Economic Times, a survey made in 2018, 93% of the engineers are not fit for hiring. Right? This is what the survey. Right? So next to selection of field,
sir,
there are two kind of jobs.
Your slide has not been moved. It is in the who is the loser in that slide. It's there.
Okay.
It's visible, sir. You unmute yourself.
Okay. There is a two kind of job. So one is saturation job, one is a value addition jobs. See, saturation job means, so even after working 5 years, right? Even after working 5 years, and if people who are working in 2 years, so they maybe 2 years experience and 5 years experience, there is no difference. So consider a driver who is having 5 years experience, and consider a driver who is having 15 years experience. A driver who is having 5 years experience, so he's a perfect in driving and he's a master in driving. And also a person who is having a 15 years experience, he is also perfect in driving, but is not adding any value to that particular job, right? So, and that experience will not gain you huge money for you. In the same way, in engineering also, there are a lot of jobs which has some saturation limits. There is a data entry job, maybe you can take any teachers. So if a teacher having 5 years experience or the teacher having 15 years experience, so there is a little growth rate in particular domain. Maybe in engineering also, some of the jobs, so while selecting a, you know, field, you should know exactly the growth in that particular domain. And value addition job, so when the experience is more and your salary is also more. So if you go for any risk analysis, if you go for a managing, you know, levels, manager levels, or if you are into productions, or if you are into developer, the more the experience, so the more the salary and the more the career growth, right? So you need to choose a domain based on your skills and interest. So not based on somebody else suggested you. So you need to think about the growth in that particular domain. So once you, if you don't consider the growth in the particular domain, so just for a sake of 5 to 10,000 salary initially, if you join some, you know, some industry where you are not interested to do the things, so after 1 or 2 years, so you cannot change the domain. What will happen? So after 2 years, if you are into marketing, so you got to know after 2 years that I am not good enough in communication, or I am not good enough in convincing skill, convincing people. So if you want to change the job, because in marketing the initial salaries are very high. So just because of salary you joined marketing, and after 2-3 years you got to know that you are not good enough, and if you want to change a domain, it will be difficult because you already wasted your 3 years experience there. And if you want to come for a technical thing, you need to start from fresh, right? So before selecting a domain, you should be careful and you should have a thorough survey about the domain. And working in a small scale industry will definitely give you a small scale, you know, better exposure in terms of knowledge and in terms of, you know, salary also, because advantages, so hands-on experience, as I already told you, so you will work in each and every aspects of business, or in each and every aspects of departments. What do you call? So you need to interact with the customers, you need to interact with the processes, you need to interact with technical things, you need to work with the clients. So you need to work with each and every department. There you will get a huge knowledge and you will come to know in which skills or in which domain you are good at. So once you know your skills, what you are good at, so then you keep on continuing that, you know, as a career. There you will build a, definitely a passion. So once work will become a passion, definitely your career will be, you know, growing. Increment also. So what do you think about increment? So you get more increment in MNC or you'll get more increment in small scale industry? Type out in a chat box. Yel jaasti sambala tagotira. Small scale industry jaasti na athwa MNC na jaasti sigutte anta na. So MNC nalli if you are a top performer, so what will be your increment? Your increment will be maximum 10 to 15%, and if you are a top performer, maybe it is a 20%, right? So but in a small scale industry, so what will happen? So your immediate boss will be the owner of the company. So he is looking you, so he is taking care of each and every business, and he knows what exactly you are doing. So if you really bring a value addition to your business, a value addition to the business or industry, you will definitely, you know, get a good salary. But when it comes to MNC, there are, you know, your seniors, managers, assistant managers, or general managers, etc., etc. There are minimum 4 to 5 managers are there. So owner is not seeing you, and their authority is to give maximum 10 to 15% hike per year. And even though you work very hard, so in an MNC, so you will get maximum increment is 15 to 20%, right?
Sir, they have given the answers as a MNC, and a few of them have given as a small scale industry.
Yes. So if you think it's an MNC, no, it is a small scale industry who are giving you enough salary. But only thing is, you need to perform well. You need to show your performance first, then you can ask any amount. The owner will definitely give you the amount, whatever you ask. Right? So attitude suits for the industry. So there is no spoon feeding in industries. So when it comes to college, so teachers are behind you, faculties are behind you, parents are behind you. So you need to work hard, you need to study hard, you need to get good marks. So in industry, nobody will teach you, nobody will spoon feed you. You need to take initiative, you need to take self-interest. Nobody will come and tell you, this is what your responsibilities, this is what you need to be done. So you need to take initiative in getting your responsibilities, right? So you need to work from labor job to leader job. Nowadays, each and every home, there is an engineer. There is no, you know, people who can work for a labor job. If you are a person who is having an attitude that I am an engineer, I don't do this kind of jobs, I can't do this kind of job, no, you will not sustain more, you know, longer in the industry. So you need to get ready for doing a labor job also, for doing a CEO job also. So this is what the attitude exactly needed in today's industries. See, performance versus leader. So if you are a performer, so how hard you will work? Maybe 8 hours a day, 12 hours a day, right? Maximum you can work for even 14 hours a day. But if you are a leader, right? If you are a leader, if you can inspire people, if you can get the things done by the people, you will definitely grow in a business, or you will definitely grow in your career, right? See, people who use their muscles to work, so will get a lesser salary. People who use their brain to work, the people who know how to manage people who know how to manage finance, people who know how to manage machineries, they are getting a huge money. So if you are a top performer, and I don't want to work with any of the colleague, my colleagues, you see, if you keep on blaming your colleagues, if you keep on blaming your subordinates, there also there is a sustainability problem. You need to work with the people. You need to have a leadership skills. You need to motivate people. Then only you will get a salary. So managers and higher level authorities are getting a more salary, not a person who is actually working in front of a system or actually working physically, right? They are not getting a huge salary. So customer satisfaction. Have you heard about customer delight? Type out S in the chat box if you have heard about delights. See, the thing is, you have a degree. So you have a degree, you have a distinction marks in the marks card. See, I have a degree of, you know, with a distinction marks, I want a job. Or else, So fulfilling the expectations of an employee versus giving him a delight. Delight in the sense, say for example, if you want to go for a, if you want to go purchase a bike. So let me tell you, so for 1 lakh rupees, you have a bike, so it has a very good design. So it gives you good mileage, it has a very good power, pickup, everything is there. And you are very much satisfied with the amount what you paid, 1 lakh rupees and the bike. So the moment when you go to showroom, they will tell you, so it's a 10% offer for you, sir. So it's a customer delight. Even it is not expected by you, right? So in the same way, the add-ons will give you more weightage for your resumes. So in your resumes, I have a first class degree in engineering. Give me a job. Or, sir, with the first class degree, I have this kind of leadership skills. I have attended this kind of internship program. Or, so I led this kind of team. So, or you are good at in sports. So add-on skills will give you weightage for your resumes. Right? So try to give a customer delight. So nowadays it's a trend, not satisfaction, it's a customer delight.
Sir, they have not heard the word delight. They have posted as a no in the chat box.
Yes. Fine. Right? So add-ons will give you more weightage in your resumes. Right? So what will be your thinking? So your thinking is salary. What is my salary? Working hours, comfort. I don't want to work, after 5 p.m. a day. So I don't want to stretch my 8 hours after 8 hours. So I need to have a comfort, comfort zone. I don't want to work hard. If you are that kind of a person, even though if you get a job, most of your seniors, they don't want to stretch their time. They don't want to work hard. They want easy job. They don't want to take, risk their life. This is what their expectation. And they want a huge salary, minimum 20,000 to 25,000 per month. See, it's not about self. It's about what is your contribution to the company? What is your contribution to your boss? What is your contribution to people? What is your contribution to society? Nobody succeeded thinking only about self. You go to any politicians, you go to any big people, they are serving people. Right? You are thinking should be what contribution I can give to company? What value addition I can provide to the company? How can I make more, revenue to the company? How can I apply my skills and knowledge so that the company will, go to the next level? If you are a person who will think in this way, definitely you will get succeeded in a job also. But normally 90% of the people are worried about their wants, not what exactly they will contribute. This is exactly the problem which is there with your seniors and the people who are struggling. Right? Fine. How many of you want to become an entrepreneur? Type out in the chat box. How many of you want to become an entrepreneur? Tell me, what is your opinion about entrepreneurship? Why you don't want to become an entrepreneur? If you don't want to become an entrepreneur, why you don't want to become an entrepreneur? See, the normal problem or the issue with the people is, I don't have enough money to start a business. Or I don't have any background support. I don't know what to do. This is what the issues with the people. So that is why people don't want to become entrepreneurs. I don't want to take any risk. If I put myself in the risk, there is a huge loss, financial loss, or maybe career, right? But if you become an entrepreneur, you will get a time freedom. You can work on your own dreams. The work will be your passion, as I told you. So the more effort you put, the more return you will get. Have you heard about time freedom and money freedom? Type out in a chat box. Have you heard about time freedom and money freedom? What is time freedom? When you go to purchase something, so when you go to a shopping mall, if you want to purchase a clothes or if you want to purchase a car, something. So the first thing what you will see is what? Price tag, right? So what is...
Financial freedom.
Yeah, exactly. See, the first thing what you see is a price tag, whether it will suit my budget or not. So money freedom is all about, without worrying about the price tag, if you wish to purchase, you will purchase it. That is what the money freedom. End of the day, money freedom will come not by working for a salary, but working on your own. See, there are people who are earning 1,000 a day, 1 lakh a day, or 1 crores per day, right? But all of them are having only 8 hours a day. But how can they are earning 1 lakh, 1 crore rupees per day? Any idea about it? See, if you are a person, if you are a performer, if you are an individual player, you have only 8 hours a day. If you work hard, maybe it may 12 hours a day. But if you are working for a salary, even though if it is a 12 hours a day, you are getting a salary according to your hour, per hour basis. If you are a 20,000 rupees salaried person, you will get another 5,000 extra if you work for another 4 hours. If you are a staff and above staff person, you will not get any OT also. It is an increment for you after 1 year of your performance. Right? But if you are a person who is an entrepreneur, if you hire 10 people who is working 8 hours a day for you, what will be your efficiency per day? 8 hours, 10 people working 8 hours a day for your dreams, for your company, it is 80 hours a day. Right? So people are earning in terms of crores. They are the entrepreneurs. They are investing money on people. And in return, they are getting a huge benefit in terms of money, in terms of time. Right? So if you are going for a salary, if you are worried only about to get a job, even though if you are a hard worker, you end up, you know, buying a 30-40 site in Bangalore. Even if you work for a lifetime, you can't even purchase a 30-40 site in the city. Right? Time freedom. What is time freedom? See, 90% of the corporate people are worried about, you know, Sundays, Saturdays. They are waiting for weekends. So Monday to Friday, they even work hard like anything. So when weekend comes, they need to go to their native or they need to clean their houses. So only few people are living their life and all of them are living the weekends. Even though they have a leave, 30 to 40 leaves per annum, they need to apply for leave. It has to be get sanctioned by higher authorities and then you will take a leave. And you need to do all your important things only, you know, if you get a leave, or else it's a Sunday, even government holidays, right? There is a saying in Kannada. See, Kannada, there is a WhatsApp message. See, when you are young, when you are a student, you have a lot of energy. You have a lot of, you know, time, but you don't have enough money to spend. So when you are working, you have a lot of energy, you have sufficient amount of money, but you don't have enough time to, you know, spend. When you are getting older and older, when you are retired, you have enough money, you have enough time, but you don't have enough energy to enjoy your life. This is what most of the salaried people are living their life. Do you really want to live that life? Or do you want to really take a, you know, second chance, take a next step so that you don't want to belong to that 90% of category of people? Type out in a chat box, how many of you want to become an entrepreneur now? See, my dear friends, you need not to invest huge money. Even I'm an entrepreneur. Basically, even I came from a middle class family. Even I don't have enough money to start my industry. But it doesn't require enough money, or you don't need to, you know, spend lakhs together money to start your own business. It's just about a small, beautiful idea. You don't need a background support. Only thing is, what problems in the society you are going to solve? One beautiful idea can change your life. There is an assumption in people's mind. So to become an entrepreneur, you need to have a lot of investment. No, it's wrong. Nowadays, there are n number of people who are ready to invest on a beautiful idea. There is a shortage of people who can solve problems in the society. But there are people who can work for someone else's dreams. You are a person, you are a salaried person, you are working on someone else's dream, not your own dream. Right? Return on investment. When you become an entrepreneur, the more you invest, the more return you will get. And also, see, when you are a salaried person, only if you go to, you know, job every day, you will get a salary. If If you don't go for a job for 1 month or 2 months, you'll not get enough salary. Now you don't even get a salary also. But when you become an entrepreneur, even though you're not going to company, even though you are sleeping, people are there to work for you. It's a time freedom. Right? If not, you need to work the whole life, even after 60 years. You need to find a job. My sincere suggestion is, don't go for a salary. It's just like a water drop. Right? So, another issue, opportunities. So, everybody is doing business. So, there are a lot of business people. I don't have any, you know, opportunity to do business. Ella tara product bandibide. So, what should I do now? Everything has been invented. See, one small story is there. So, chapli maron irthane, oba chapli maron, right? So, a slipper seller, footwear seller, so went to some company. Ondo company anadikina, ond deshak hogtane. So, there, people don't know anything about footwear. They don't even know about it. They don't even heard about footwear. Chapli andre enu antane gotirala. Tumba dura nedkondu hogtane. So, nedkondu alli aa deshadalli chapli maradakke anta hogtane. Right? Alli enagutte, once he saw, so nobody is wearing the slippers and nobody, you know, don't even know what the slipper is all about. So he is very much discouraged. Yenappa maadli illi, what I can do here? So tumba dura nadkonu bandbute, I don't have any options here to do business. He went back. Tumba bejaralu vapas bartane. So for same country, so ade deshakke innobba hogtane. So another footwear seller will go to the same location. I'll hogtane, hog nodtane. So he said, wow, nobody knows what exactly the footwear is all about. If I make them use the slippers, or avrige artha maadisidre, athwa avrige nanu slipper na use madodana helikotre, if I teach them how to use footwear, the whole market is mine. I don't have any competitors. Only thing is your attitude towards the problem. So first person saw it is a barrier for him to do the business, and the second person saw it as an opportunity, right? See, only thing is, it's your attitude towards a problem. My dear friends, there is a shortage of people who can solve problems in the society. There is a shortage of people. If you are a problem solver, if you are a solution provider, definitely you can also become an entrepreneur, right? Qualities to become an entrepreneur: you need to have a very good case studies, you need to be a good in case studies, so you need to have particular knowledge on particular field, managerial skills. See, if you are a performer, no, business is not for you. You need to be a leader. You need to know all the managerial skills, financial skills, people management, leadership skills, how to inspire people, how to manage time, how to manage money. You need to take a right decision, motivation, self-motivation, hard work, discipline. So very important to become an entrepreneur. And you need to be very creative in solving your problems, right? What exactly needed to become an entrepreneur is never give up attitude. My dear friend, there is no dull student or bright student. The amount of time you invested on a particular thing, that decides who you are. If you are investing a lot of time in studying, so you will get a rank, you will get a very good marks. If you are investing a lot of time in gym or sports, you will become super fit. Right? If you invest a lot of time to become an entrepreneur, or to think about how to become an entrepreneur, you will definitely become an entrepreneur. It's all about where you are investing your valuable time. Right? So as a student, you have a lot of time, but you need to think where exactly you need to invest your time. Time is money, right? See, there's no failure. Failure is just a linguistic thought. People have a language, right? Lion, deer, see, lion will go to, you know, hunt their food, right? Betta hogutte So it fails. Even if it fails 50 times, even if it fails 100 times, it will not say, I am a failure. So it will go 101 times, it will go and it will try and it will get the food. But only a man in his language created the language, the word called failure. Right? You need to be like a lion. It's all about never give up attitude. So why most of the business, so it fails? What is the reason for failure? There is nothing much uniqueness in a business model. See, somebody did, you know, a bakery and I also want to do, you know, bakery. Somebody developed an app, I want to do, you know, similar kind of app. Somebody build a machine, I want to do the same machine. There is no uniqueness, right? Even though there are n number of manufacturers, mobile manufacturer, why Apple is in the first place? He created his own uniqueness. There is a formula in a business. Either do it first or do it unique. If you are a person who is a first timer, I told you a slipper story, footwear seller story. He is the first time in that country. It's a huge success. Or even though there are n number of people who can manufacture footwear, how unique your product is, that defines your success rate in a business. And market survey, I told you, see, how you see, how you look into the issues, how you look into the problems, market survey really matters, right? Knowledge, less knowledge. If you want to start a footwear business, or if you want to start something, you know, manufacturing, if you don't know exactly what knowledge is needed to start that business or to run the shop, it's a failure. There's no dedication. If you think you have a lot of money and I will go and I start my own business. No, even people are having a lot of money, they can't even start a business. Or if you have a lot of knowledge, no, you can't do anything only with the knowledge, right? You need to manage people. You need to manage finances. You need to inspire people. You need to upgrade every day. Learning is a continuous process. Once you come out from the college, if you think, so I have learned everything, now there is nothing to learn, you are a fool. See, sustainability, what I can say, first mobile, when it comes to market, what is the name of that company? It's a Nokia, right? First time yavad bandiddu ivat mobile antandre nam kaaladallella, it's a Nokia bitre mobile irlila, right? But today Nokia has no name in the market. Do you know why? They were the leaders, but they didn't worry about the sustainability. They didn't worry about that upgradation. They didn't worry about their competitors. End of the day, they thought, we are successful, we don't have any competitor as of now. They didn't work hard to sustain their business. So within a few years, Nokia is nowhere, right? Anybody can succeed, but if you don't plan your sustainability, you cannot be longer in the business. Improper organization structure. You need to build a strong team of people, right? So what is the alternate for entrepreneurship? By taking a responsibility in a small scale industry. There are n number of industries who are looking for leaders. There are a lot of problems in the small scale industry. If you are a person who can solve problems in that particular industry with all the skills you develop in the college, you can become an entrepreneur. If you perform well in a small scale industry, even you can get a share also, right? Not to worry about salary. If you are a person, so when you joined a small scale industry, it's a 50 lakh turnover. When you entered after 1 year, it becomes 2 crore. You can get a share, 20 lakh rupees per annum. You need not to worry about getting 10 to 15,000 salary, right? Only thing is you need to acquire a lot of skills to run a business. And you need to perform and show the results, right? It's not only a small scale industry. You can go to any business which is struggling now. You can go to any business which is struggling to earn the money. Apply your skills. apply your leadership skills, apply your management skills, make the business grow and get a share. Value addition to existing business. You can go to education sector, you can go to small scale industries, you can, even if you can go to a ration store. ಈ ರೇಷನ್ ಅಂಗಡಿಗೆ ಹೋದ್ರೂ ಕೂಡ ಅಲ್ಲೂ ಟು ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಎನ್ ಆ್ಯಪ್ ಇದು ಮಾಡಿ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟಾಗಿ ಮನೆಗಳಿಗೆ ಹೇಗೆ ಡೆಲಿವರಿ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಎ ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ವೇರ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್, ಯು ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಎನ್ ಆಪ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ರೇಷನ್ ಅಂಗಡಿ, ರೈಟ್? ಆ ಸ್ಟೋರಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಆ್ಯಪ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಅಟ್ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಒಂದು ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಏರಿಯಾನ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕವರ್ ಇಟ್, ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಹಿ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ಸಮ್ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಎನಿ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್. ಸೊ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸೋಫಾ ಮ್ಯಾನುಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಚರರ್ or something, some person who is having a very unique product but he don't know how to sell his product, or he don't know how to, you know, make a bigger scale. You go and you apply your thoughts, you apply your knowledge, and you can also become an entrepreneur. See, entrepreneurial skills lead you to become a second line of leaders. Do you think a Toyota owner is working, you know, day and night in a company? He created a second line of leaders. Each and every bigger company, they created a second line of leaders and they are running the show. And the owner is enjoying his time freedom, he is enjoying his money freedom. Right? So, if you acquire all these skills and knowledge, you will climb the highest position within a short period of time. Only thing is, you need to know how to become an entrepreneur and how to run a business. How to apply your skills in a creative way so that you bring success in that particular business. And you need to be very much good in influencing people. If you are an influencer through online, you will get a lot of money. Be a solution provider. Don't go on asking for a job. See, I have a distinction, I need a job. No. Go to company and ask them what solution I can give. What is your problem? Tell me, I will solve the problem. If this will be your attitude, definitely you will succeed 10 times faster than your seniors are, or 90% of the people who are struggling right now. Right? As I told you earlier, no investment required to become an entrepreneur. It's just one beautiful idea. Right? There is a two kind of success. One is societal success versus self success. Have you heard about societal success? Type out in the chat box. What is societal success? You are a top performer. You have a very good salary. You are working in Infosys as a team lead, getting 1 lakh rupees per month salary. You have very, you know, your own house, having car. You are having a beautiful life. Society will think that, yeah, yes, he is a successful person. But what exactly you are dealing with, nobody knows. You are working very hard, Monday to Friday, waiting only for weekends, paying EMIs. But people think that you are a successful person. You don't know the frustrations in the corporate sector. What is self-success? Finding your passion, what you are good at. Right? Even though the salary is very less, and if you are satisfied with what you are doing, it leads to a self-success. End of the day, money doesn't make you happy. Right? It's your passion. What drives you in a business? What problems you can solve in a society? If you think in this way, if your thinking will be like this, if your thinking should be like this, then only you will definitely succeed. Right? So, Ticey. What is Ticey? Team of industrial experts creating entrepreneurs through education. This year we started this program. What exactly we are doing in this Ticey means removing all the risk from your life, creating a beautiful platform to perform so that even though you don't have any investment, even though you don't have any background support, we will support you in becoming an entrepreneur. And each and every stages of business, we will be there with you to support and to guide you. This is all about Ticey. So why we entered into education sector? What happened even after interviewing? From last 6 years, I have interviewed thousands of other students. Even after interviewing 100 candidates, we are not getting one best candidate. fed up with doing interview. Poor industrial technical knowledge in students when it comes to, when I compare to their salary expectations. They need salary of 20-25,000 at least. But when it comes to interview, when we interview them, no skills. Only if there is a mark in a mask card. We got frustrated. Even out of 100, not even one possesses the entrepreneur's desires. Nobody wants to become an entrepreneur. See, there are n number of people who are seeking for a job. There are lakhs together people. But who is going to provide you a job if you don't become an entrepreneur? If you are not a, you know, job provider, then who will going to give a job to you? Not even 1 in 100. Forget not 1 in 1,000. How you get a job? Right? See, what is our vision? To enrich the value addition to education system that enables the students to develop qualitative entrepreneurial thoughts and to be in par with industrial and corporate requirements. In short words, we want to create the native entrepreneurs and we want to make students industry ready. Right? What is our mission? So we are partnering with engineering colleges. Each and every district, we are going to have a partnership with the engineering colleges. There, we are going to train you throughout 4 years of your engineering about entrepreneurship, about industrial requirements, about campus placement, everything. Right? We are supporting you in each and every stages of entrepreneurial journey. Right? We will teach you how to think creatively. We will make you industry ready candidates, right? From you know, the way how you bring an idea, how to bring an idea. So from idea stage to successful, you know, fundraising maadi until you become a successful entrepreneur. So we are with you. What we are doing, attaching micro and small scale industries to the institutions. So while you are studying in third year, final year, you are parallelly, you are working with a small scale industry there. You are solving problems in the industries. We will guide you first 2 years about your attitudes, about how to create, you know, solutions, how to find a problem. Then in the third year and fourth year, we will going to tie up with the small scale industries or businesses where you will solve problems in the industries. Thereby you are working live with the industries when you are as you are a student. So allowing you to solve problems in MSME, you will be trained on various aspects of running a business. So like how to bring an idea, how to survey the market, risk analysis, how to create a beautiful structure for a business, how to fundraise, so how to manage people and how to think about sustainability. This is what we are going to teach throughout the 4 years. So one part is entrepreneurial and the second part is industrial experts who are having more than 5+ years experience. They will come to college and they will teach you the current trends in the engineering or current trends in the market. It is training from industrial experts, maybe on entrepreneurs or managers. So engineers from various domains will come to college and will teach you what exactly you need to develop. So providing opportunities in the small scale industries, there will be a unique coaching techniques. Internship will be provided on real time projects, not to, you know, just for the sake of certificates. Continuous mentoring on personality development. Right? It's not a 1 day, 2 day program, soft skills program, or it's a motivational story. No, we are with you. We will be with you throughout 4 years. Supporting you how to run the show. There will be a continuous training on roles and responsibilities across departments that are likely to be fulfilled after you getting into the corporate world. So connecting with institution directly with high profile companies, we will support you in connecting high profile companies as there are industrial experts who are coming to college and teaching about the current trends. You will get a huge network with the people, corporate sector. Right, unique and strategic approach to HR, Building a network among students and corporate people by utilizing social media platform. How many of you are utilizing the social media to build your career? You are investing a lot of time in WhatsApp, Facebook, right? What exactly are you utilizing from a social network? We will teach you how to utilize social media platform. Networking and continuous communication with alumni of college. How you get a job? If you have a reference, you will likely to get a more job. Or if you go and apply resumes and you will get a job. Which is very quicker? I put in the chat box. If you have a reference, you will get a job very quickly, right? So what is the promise of the program? Get hired by the top companies with high package salaries. This is the promise of the program. Make yourself ready to hire by the industries, acquiring top positions in the company in a very short span. Know the industrial expectations as a fresher. Learn to become rich and wealthy. Become an entrepreneur with zero investment. I repeat, become an entrepreneur with zero investment. This is the promise of the program. But the thing is, you can ask me, what is the guarantee? With the discipline, already told. If you do the program the way it is meant to be, not the way you want it to be, we will guarantee you. It's a 100% success. Discipline is all about do what is necessary, whether you like it or not. If you really want to succeed in life, whether you like it or not, you need to work hard. You need to follow the guidelines. And integrity in each and every aspects of what you do. Right? Integrity means it's not studying for the sake of marks or to show someone that I did my internship here, not for a certificate sake. Integrity in each and every aspects of what you do to gain a knowledge, to give value addition. See, from now onwards, think what value addition I can give to my employer, my company, my society, my community, my nation. If you are a person who think in this way, yes, the entrepreneurial platform is for you, right? You are not going to spoon feed. ನಿಮಗಿಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲದನ್ನು ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಡ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ ಆ ರೀತಿ ಇದನ್ನ ಮಾಡಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಮಾಡಿ ಸೊ ವಿ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿಹೈಂಡ್ ಯು ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಯೂನಿಕ್ ಕೋಚಿಂಗ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಲರ್ನ್ ದ ನೋ ಹೌ ಈವನ್ ದೋ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ನೋಬಡಿ ವಿಲ್ ಟೀಚ್ ಯು ಬಟ್ ನಿಮಗೆ ನೀವೇ ಹೇಗೆ ತಿಳ್ಕೋಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೌ ಅವರ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸ್ಪೂನ್ ಫೀಡ್ ಯು ರೈಟ್ So knowing where to invest is also very important. Poor people value money, but rich people value time. Example, enappa antandre, see, for to do some training, so you need to invest a lot of money, right? Maybe 10,000, 20,000, 50,000 rupees. But if you learn from your mistakes, if you want to learn from your mistake, it will take minimum 6 months, one year, or it may be 10 years. See, there is a saying. See, as soon as you hire a mentor in your life, you will definitely succeed 10 times faster than the normal people who don't have a mentor. Right? Because do not reinvent the wheel. Kelidira, nimma tappindane elladannu neevu kalita hogbedi. Learn from others' mistakes also. Right? Key notes of this program. Hire mentors as early as possible. History writing. Do you know why history will be written? Yak history barithar gottidya? Type out in a chat box. Do not reinvent the wheel. Andre, so hinde enen madidare history nalli adrinda enenella results bandide what went wrong olled enaytu kettud enaytu so adanella odadrinda kuda so neevu olle decision tagondo success aagabodu do not reinvent the wheel andre So in the arrow 10 years back, somebody has invented a wheel, but you don't know anything about a wheel and you haven't read it. So while doing something, you also invented a wheel and you are happy about, and you invested another 1 year, 2 years to upgrade the wheel. After 2 years, you will come to know. So it has been invented 10 years back. Do not reinvent the wheel. Learn not from your mistakes alone, but also from the mentors, coaching. Invest on brain, not on trial and errors. Trial and errors already done by your seniors. Go and ask them. Don't do your own trial and errors. Ask your seniors how they studied, what went wrong. I have given a rough idea about how they did. Evaluate whatever I said, whether it is right or wrong. Right? Save time by hiring a mentor. Money in the bank doesn't grow fast as it grows in the brain. Invest on training and mentoring. The biggest cost which anybody pays is the cost of ignorance. It means if somebody says something, if somebody gives a suggestion, so somebody, a resource person came to you and I have suggested a lot of things about industry or, you know, his experience. And if you ignore those words, those suggestions, it is the highest cost what you are paying. Right? People don't want to spend to upgrade their skills, but expect them to pay highest salaries. It's just like, you know, you want to grow a plant, but you don't want to water it. Do you think it's possible? See, Kannadadal, there is a saying, Bevu bitti mavu veleva tirukanase yetako. See, what you sow, you reap, right? So, it is your first year. You started a journey with a beautiful college, with highly professionals, faculties. Make use of it, right? What do you want to become? Entrepreneur or an employee? Type out in a chat box. There is a story of a frog. There is a special character. It can adjust its skin to any temperature, till up to an 80 to 100 degree, right? So, one frog na stove mel it puto, adrolog neer ak puto, a frog na neer olgade bit puto, heat madak bide yenta. So, frog has a special character, it will adjust. So, once the temperature rises, 10 degree hoito, so it is, you know, adjusting. Adjust maadkota hoitu 10 degree adru skin na adjust maadkotu, so 20 degree aitu 30 degree aitu, it has a capability to adjust to different skin temperatures. 40 degree it is having a capability, it is adjusting, adjust maadkota hoitu 50 maadkotu. Once it crosses 70 degree, it knows, oh, I cannot adjust anymore. So alli gotadaga enaytadu, so suddenly it tries to jump from out from the bowl. ಬಟ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಏನಾಯಿತು ಅಂದರೆ ಅದರ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದ್ರಲ್ಲೇ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿತ್ತು ಅಂತ. 10 degree 20 degree ಟೆಂಪ್ರೇಚರಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಈಸಿ ಫಾರ್ ಫ್ರಾಗ್ ಟು ಜಂಪ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಬೌಲ್. ಬಟ್ 80 degree ಅದರ ಎನರ್ಜಿನೆಲ್ಲ ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಕಳೆದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನೆಗೆಯೋದಕ್ಕೂ ಔಟ್ ಜಂಪ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೂ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಏನಾಯಿತು, ಫ್ರಾಗ್ ಸತ್ತೋಯ್ತು ಅಂತ. ಹಾಗೆ ನಿಮಗೂ ಕೂಡ ಕಂಫರ್ಟ್ ಝೋನಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೇಗೋ ನಡೆಯುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, so the way your seniors are struggling right now, you will also definitely struggle in the same way. But if you don't want to follow your seniors,
sir,
if you
really want to
take any step, yes, please.
Their answer is entrepreneur.
Yes, thank you. So decide today what do you want to become, and with the never give up attitude. Whether you want to become an entrepreneur, definitely you can become an entrepreneur. See, one small, say for example, ivat aeroplane annadu gotte irlilla, yaru kande hidirilla ankoli. Hauda, car ittu, bike ittu, ella ittu, but aeroplane yaru kande hidirilla. So nan bandibittu nan aeroplane kandidithini, naale it will go in a speed of 1000 km per hour, so samudra ella cross martini andre people definitely laugh at you, right? Same thing. If people don't laugh at your dreams are too small. If people don't laugh at your dreams are too small. Aeroplane kandidiyadiki ivat agutte anta 100 jana ankondre there is no opportunity. Yavaga ellaru idu agalla nan kaiyalli ankotare adanna neevu start martiralla, there is an opportunity, there is a success. Only thing is your attitude towards the problems. Right? So tuition fee for our program is 10,000 per student per year. Throughout the 4 years, we are going to train you in each and every aspects of entrepreneurship with a different domain. So you need not worry about domain. So if you are a software, if you are into computer science, if you are into mechanical, if you are into civil, people from different domains with the same domain will come and teach you how to become an entrepreneur. We'll support you in technical things, upgradation, industry ready, everything will be trained. The tuition fee for this program is 10,000 rupees per student per annum, right? If you are interested, note down our WhatsApp number. You can text us, right? And please like our page, Ticy. There is a Facebook page, Instagram. So if you follow, we will give you the updates. What are all the programs we are conducting? How we are going? You will get to know the students who are already into our programs, their sharings, right? So if you are really interested to become an entrepreneur, see, outside the cost is too high. You need to invest lakhs together money to learn these skills. If you go to any of a coaching, you know, mentors online, you go to Dev Gadvi or Rajiv Talleja, there are n number of people who will train you on entrepreneurship. They will take for 3 days, 20,000 rupees, and for 6 months to 1 year, they will charge minimum 3 to 5 lakhs. As a student, for you, what we are offering is just 10,000 rupees. Right? So you can WhatsApp us. Thank you. Thank you so much. Have a nice evening.
Thank you, sir. It was very informative session for the budding engineers who want to be an entrepreneur. Our student will adopt the never give up attitude.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you so much. If you have any questions, please let me know. So I'm here to answer.
I'm waiting, sir. If any question comes in the chat box, I'll update you, sir.
Sure.
Madam, you can read out what they have written. No, maybe let him also. Is it accessible to him? Chat box?
1 second, sir. No, it's not. No, sir, it's
sir,
not accessible.
Actually, in between when he asked the questions, they have messaged him. But okay. Here, finally, the image was
fine, madam. You can give him some feedback. No, what
my
students
image was
have written
to get a job in a famous company. By hearing this, my opinion is only that would be wonderful. That's what the
yeah, madam. Yeah, Tungraj, students are thanking you for the session.
Yes,
are thanking you for the session. I think you have motivated them, and this is what we were looking for. Okay, Tungraj, anyhow, we'll be in touch. We'll take up whatever we were planning. Okay, thank you very much for taking the session. We look forward to have a continued association with you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Madam, formally, can we wind up?
Yes, sir. Thank you,
madam.
Yes, sir. So now I thank Dr. Ratnakar, Dean Student Affairs, for being a part of this function. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, madam. Thank you.
I also thank all the students, HODs of various departments for participating in this program. Thank you, sir. Thank you all. Tomorrow, as usual, we will be having 4 sessions. Monday, first session is UHV, and second session will be addressed by Kalpana ma'am, an IAS officer. And third session will be a department introduction. And fourth session, you will be having a creative arts. And you have to give the feedback for every session, which I am posting in your WhatsApp group. Thank you all.
Thank you, Thungraj. I personally thank you for all the committed efforts. So thank you, all the students, for participating. Thank you, Priyanka Madam, for your continued working on this induction program. Thank you all. We'll wind up the session. Thank you.
Welcome. Welcome. Thank you all. Thank you. Bye. Bye.